Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, before we start, I need to amend the agenda. I need to add information on the hiring of a probationary firefighter. It wasn't on there, so just put it down there under the mayor section. Do I need that motion?
That would move to the agenda.
Okay, second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Today is Monday, February 6, 2017. Time is 5 p.m. and the meeting of the Greensburg Board of Works is called to order. At this time, please silence electronic devices. Okay. To comply with Title VI of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, the city requests that participants in this meeting complete a voluntary anonymous survey that is available on the table in the back of the room. That's that gray box, and there's stuff there if you guys wouldn't mind filling out a little paperwork. Roll call vote, please.
Carol Perkins.
Vote.
Awesome. Rick Emsweller.
Here.
Lynn Tebby.
Here.
Carol Holden.
Here.
Okay. Now we need to approve the minutes. Let's do January 3rd. First, do you have any changes or comments?
We move approval.
Okay, I need a second.
Second.
Any questions? All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? January 17th. Any corrections on that one?
Move for approval.
Okay, a second?
Second.
Any other questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
So passed. Okay, let's see. Old business, none. New business. Fall Festival, where are you? There you are.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Mark Carman, Vice President of this year's Fall Festival. We are back. Some people may not think that's a good thing, but we're hoping to make this a much better, much improved over all past fall festivals. I'm here to ask for the use of the street for the parade on Saturday and for the closure of the square for the Friday and Saturday festivals. It's going to be the same route for the parade as in the past, no changes. Same time, I don't know, I don't have that time in front of me, but whatever that time was in the past, it will be that same time.
10 a.m. on Saturday.
10 a.m. Prep time before that, probably 9 o'clock to set up, start time at 10, run for the duration of the parade. The Friday night, what we would probably need, closure in the square on Thursday night for setup of vendors. 5 o'clock, that would let the downtown merchants close up. If there are people out, we would not need to close before, prior to that. We could probably even go 6 o'clock if that would be warranted that you guys would need that. And then Friday and Saturday, we would tear down Saturday night. Square would be open back up as soon as tear down was done. I have a copy of our bank account if you need that for insurance. I have a copy of the parade route. And I have a copy of the square closure that we would need, if you need to see a copy of that.
Has it changed any from previous years?
As of right now, we're having a vote tomorrow night on a beer garden. It's probably going to get voted down, so you'll not have to worry about that. There's three members who want one. Everybody else does not want one. As far as I know, there are no other major changes. The stage would be set up on the corner of Washington and Broadway, like in the past. As far as anything else, no, I don't think there's any other changes.
You talked to department heads?
Yes, I've spoken with all of them. I gave Mr. Klosterkamper a copy of the routes. I've spoken with fire chief and police chief, and they are all go for it.
Okay. I don't know if there's any reason to say that. So. I mean, it's coming back, and we're going to go after it, so
yes,
let's support it.
Thank you.
I have a motion that we
I will move that we authorize closure of the square for the fall festival date, September 15 and 16, beginning on the evening prior. Time to be determined by the mayor, and parade route as previous occasions of use.
Second? I'll second. Any questions?
I do have one. Are you going to provide us with a copy of the insurance?
Once we have it secured, we have the bank account statement to show that we have the ability, and we have someone that we are going to contact, but
right.
They suggest that we not pay for it prior to about a month out, so we're not paying for something we're not using.
Okay. That'd be the only concern I have.
I would add that provision that it be conditioned upon proof of insurance.
We will secure that and present that to you as soon as we have it.
Okay.
That's an amendment. Is that agreeable to you?
That works.
All right.
That works. Okay. Any other questions? Okay. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. You're open.
Thank you.
Whatever, however you want to put it.
Thanks. Okay, next on the list is road closure for Eagles Wing 5K.
Good evening, I'm Brian Wenning here representing the On Eagles Wings 5K run and walk, and we are asking the Board of Works to be able to close some streets for our annual walk, and that is on August 26th. This year. And I've given you a map. You can kind of see how the route is, and that is similar to the past 5Ks that we've done. This is the fifth year, and last year we had 950 participants, so we've still got a pretty good crowd coming, so we'd like to be able to again close these down. And the actual run starts at 9 a.m. About 8 o'clock is when we would close it, and about 10 o'clock is when we would open it. About all the runners and walkers are out of there, like off of the streets by 10 o'clock. So it'd be about a 2-hour window to close it down. I have spoken to Brandon, police chief, and Steve, the fire chief, and Mark, the street commissioner, about any issues, and they are all on board with it.
We've not had any issues in the past 4 years, so.
No, we haven't that I know of, no.
Not that's come to my attention.
Mm-hmm. I did hear. You went to the county?
Yes. This morning I did go to the county and ask about having Non-Millhouse Road to be 60 East closed at 300 South for a temporary time for 2 hours this morning also, and they agreed with that.
Make a motion to grant the road closure for 5K wrong way Eagles names. Eagles names.
Easy to read.
Second.
I would second that, please.
Okay. Any other questions for Brian?
We do have insurance to the Archdiocese of Indianapolis, if that's a question. We have a $2 million policy. So, and we have shown that in the past to the, I know that's been asked to the Board of Works a couple of times, a couple of meetings or years ago or so, but we do have proof of that if that's warranted or needed.
Should be on file.
I think, but I, again, I don't know, but we have given that in the past. A copy of that.
Yeah, let's take a picture. Do have a copy.
Sure.
Are you gonna be busing them in again?
No, we, the first year we had over 1,200 participants. And now that we have our parking and the more parking out there, the last 2 years, we haven't done that. We've been able to park on site, which has worked out real well.
Okay. So, not hearing any more questions? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, passes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you. Good luck. Okay. Next, we got Chief Bridges.
Good evening. First on the agenda is purchase of laptops. Last year, we've replaced 10. This year, I'm looking to replace 7. Five of those will be replacements that are currently in patrol cars, and 2 would be for the new hires. I'm asking the board's approval for a total cost of $8,816.55. This is going to be through Dell, which is a state bid, and these will also contain the solid state hard drive, which will allow the hard drives to hold up to the vibration and the driving conditions of city alleys, railroad tracks, and stuff like that. So they should hold up better with the solid state hard drives.
Budget, right?
Yes.
And it's within the budget that you allotted, so.
Correct.
Now 5, you're getting rid of what?
Right now they will be at station. And then I know we had talked previously last year that the fire department wanted to test any of those out in the engines due to the new CAD system they could. So that offer would still be up. I don't know if any other city departments would have a need for the computers. Again, all we would have to do is do some erasing of some of the files in that. But like I said, just depends on if any of the other departments need it.
So they'd be there for use if by yourselves as well.
Correct.
If something would happen.
Correct.
So will these be on rotation then in the future, or how long do you expect these to be operational?
I'm hoping they actually last the life of the vehicle, and that they go with the rotation of the cars. When these laptops were first purchased, I believe in 2012, 2013, they're purchased all in one. And then, of course, we started running into the hard drive issues. That's my goal, would be to rotate them out with cars. And I have spreadsheets already listed on what year they're implemented into the field and when the cars are planning on going out for rotation, so that should all be followed in.
Spend up to $8,816.55
for the car. Second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, next on the list is the selection of the 20th officer.
guess I'll take a recommendation on the board on 20th officer.
Well, we did interview three candidates, and as I recall, we were looking at number two as the hire that we, as our first choice. I would move that we would authorize the chief and the mayor to engage the second number two on our list here as for additional employment pending PERF and other requirements being met.
Okay. Second. Okay. Any questions? Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Bill passes.
Thank you.
Get a hold of that person.
Will do. Last thing on the list is a policy amendment on evidence. Last year, or the year, I can't remember now. Actually, I guess it was 2015. We redid a little bit of the evidence control room policy. In the audit and destruction of some of the property, we found that currently our policy was lacking a disposal of property, section. And well, the problem we run into is if there's any found property that comes off the street, right now we actually don't have any way of disposing of it. Before, we had to do a court order, and we had over 6,000 pieces of property in the room that we had to go through and all that. This amendment, which would be Section H, would be the disposal of found property. Last year, I had Captain of Investigations and the evidence clerk go to a class on evidence control, and it was recommended to them that there's something put in place to where if an officer comes across any type of found property, that it would stay in our possession for 90 days, and we would try to get a hold of the owner if possible, or wait until possibly somebody would come in and ask if we had found something. After that, the 90 days, then that would be destroyed in a proper manner. I've been asked on certain pieces of property. The biggest one we have, of course, is knives, things like that that get turned into us, driver's licenses, and that to where, again, people never do come in and claim those, so we would just be able to legally destroy those through the city ordinance. I was asked about what we would do on monetary, the money that would possibly be found on the street. Again, we would wait the 90 days. If it was not claimed, then per state law, this is coming from the evidence clerk, there's a state law that states that that money would be put into the city's portion of the budget for the police pension part. So that would go into police pension fund. I've already spoken with briefly with the clerk treasurer about it and made her aware of it. I did send this to the city attorney, asked for his recommendation. And he came back just stating that I might want to put something in to what found property would be. So that's why I added the 1A and put that the found property would be any property that does not have any evidentiary means. And again, we would check with the prosecutor before anything was destroyed just to make sure. But that's what I'm asking the boards for approval of to the amend this policy to allow us to get rid of found property.
I have no reason. I mean, it makes sense and certainly support that. Just because of a personal question, not a personal question, but a personal experience. What would you do if somebody brought you a small bicycle?
Bicycle. Used to be, we would have to store them in our facility for 90 days. Or however long we wanted to pass that 90 days, and then we would have to go get a court order, and they used to take them to Manus's, and I believe maybe the city got a dollar per bike The only issue that we ran into was we don't have the space in our facilities now to hold bikes. So we do not pick up bikes anymore unless we run their serial number and we found that they are stolen. Then we will bring them up to the police department. But except right now it would be up to the either the property owner whose bike that was left on. They can do what they want, leave it out for trash, take it up to the recycling and scrap it. But again, that's what we do with bikes now. Because a lot of times, unfortunately, when bikes are taken, they're damaged to where the owners don't even try to come up and find the bikes anymore because they know that the bike's been stripped out or something to where it's not worth too much to them anymore.
Okay. It just, yeah, that didn't happen to me. And I, of course, I did bring it to you all thinking somebody might call you to see if it was found.
Right.
And, all right.
Okay. So, any other questions?
This is just a procedural thing that we can, you obviously need support for. So, I would move adoption of the amendment to the policy on evidence of custody.
At the age.
Second.
Any other questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Passes.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Mark Costigan, superintendent, request for disposal of equipment.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Got four small items. Right at the end of the year, we finally were able to get the new phones that were placed throughout most of the other departments earlier. ETC's got most of the bugs worked out of them. At least they're functioning. It's fantastic. We can actually call the city hall. We can transfer calls. And what I've got is two old phones. Both of them are old enough, they've never shown up on a sheet. I can't tell you how old they are. They're functional. I don't think anybody wants them. They're rather small. There's nothing special about them. The other two items were a couple of printers. One of them was in the front where my assistant's at. The other one's one the mechanic was utilizing. Neither have been working well due to the environment we're in with the amount of dust and dirt. And because of some consolidation in the engineering department here, they had a couple of extra printers, so we didn't buy any. We got a couple of theirs that they weren't utilizing. We put those in the place of these two. So all four items, we don't have a use for whatsoever. I would say the phones are obsolete. They won't work with anything we have now because we're digital. These are analog phones. The printers need them while we're working properly.
Yeah.
They'll go February 25th to the e-waste day at the fairground and be gone.
So moved.
Several items I need to dispose of. The first two items I'll probably take out of the cars. The motors are in good shape. The problem is the fingers over this. I don't feel comfortable about selling them in public because I feel like it might be too involved in a lawsuit later on. The rest of the items are just items when we did our remodeling or some of our construction projects that were left over need to be disposed of. The other ones are the two samplers, the signal samplers. They were the ones we had in our headworks. Headworks is very hard on samplers because they had to be refrigerated. They took out the aluminum coils. Since that time, we've changed to a hot sampler, and they're totally enclosed, which we haven't had any problems with hot. So I need to dispose of those two samplers. We also have some ventilation equipment, five-minute escape air packs, gas monitoring equipment, and some cylinders. They were all the scuba stuff that we had. It's been down there since I was there in 98. The problem is, they're totally outdated. Last time we had the guys in, they said we need to just take the regulators off, but the air tanks have probably been out, and then we need to dispose them, like the top spray there or something like that, because they're not safe to be charged anymore. And I think the safety committee came up the last time. Since we don't have any really chlorine down or anything, we have a problem, and we'll call the fire department. I think that was, we have to go in some place. Normally, what we do is we have gas monitors. We monitor the enclosed space, monitor the gas. We just pump in fresh air and keep the fresh air pumped in. The monitors are safe to go in. So we don't usually go have anybody down in the fire space. The other ones were the aqua aerators and some motors. The aqua aerators were on old plant one. They were done away with when we did our construction in 2008, 2009. And we just need to dispose them. We don't have any use for those anymore. And the last one was one of the motors during the plant expansions. Basically, we kept it.
So you will see if you can get anything or just take the junk?
Yeah, we'll take it. We'll probably go out and take it to Brookhart and how much I'll give, because I can figure out the weight on it up here on the tonnage.
And some of these other pieces will just have to go?
We'll take those to the junk and scrap them out.
There's no use.
I need to get them off our assets.
Okay.
Any
other questions? You can make a motion to get rid of the stuff.
So good. In your room.
Okay. Any other questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay.
I think it's pretty good.
That's good. That is good. Okay. And then it's me, Donna. I think this is Umbaugh, who's part of yours for budget.
It's an accounting agreement for different odds and ends. We don't currently have a contract with them for different accounting questions. PERF regulations, we have to, it's GASB 68 and 71. Accounting principles, we have to account for all the PERF liabilities. And they sent me the report PERF did, and I'm like, I don't really know exactly what to do. And I'd rather have their expertness for that than a lot of the bond issues and odds and ends that I might have. So it's a not to an exceed contract. It lists all of the partners or whomever would work on some of the questions that we would have per case basis. The not to exceed, I think, is $21,000, which is based on our company. Companies, plural, water and this wastewater, and it goes by how many, what your expenses are. So that was the number that Andre Riley came up with. We wouldn't even get close to that, but it would just be a working contract where we can get questions answered. We haven't been audited since, had a state audit since 2012 either, so I'd like them to review year end and get all our journal entries intact.
Okay.
would appreciate the agreement. I think the mayor is actually the one that would sign it.
Any questions? This comes out of water.
It would be split between water and wastewater, yes.
This company's familiar, I mean, Umbaugh's been with the city for a long time. They're familiar with who we are and what we've done, and they're very reputable. I have great confidence in their, I see no reason not to. I think it would be prudent for us to have it.
Yes, they do a wonderful job.
So I guess that's a motion.
You want, yeah, I could move that in a way, I'd love it.
Sounds good.
Need a second?
I'll say.
Any other questions? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So passed.
Thank you.
Is this what you need, Donna?
Yes.
Okay. Next is agreement for firefighter services. The top one is Washington Township. Basically, the contract we've had with them for many years. They basically assist us with the building of Station 2. They also supply equipment. So, this is their contract.
Same as we've had?
Yes.
Yeah. So we're just renewing it for this year?
Yes. Just for this year.
I'll move for renewal.
Need a...
Second.
Second. Have any other questions? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So passed. Okay. Next, I have the fire protection contracts and services for out in our county areas that they'll live and all that. These are old contracts from last year, but I wanted to make sure this formula is still okay with you guys to use. I don't know what formula, what else we'd use. This is the same formula we've used in the past. So I just wanted to double check and make sure.
I don't know. I know that it's based on the assessed value and the cost per hundred. We've got here is basically 31 cents per, and then it's the different values for different. And I don't know how the values were initially determined or how they were arrived at, if they've been adjusted any time in the last few years. Do you know that?
I would say that they was probably taken from the assessment last year because they're showing 2015.
Well, yeah, so I mean, it's always years and years.
Yeah.
It's the value of the property properties, I don't, that's set, there's a formula for that. I just don't know how they've arrived at the fire protection cost is based on the, there's the multiplier there. And I don't know exactly what, how that multiplier has been determined. One company is 92, another it's 24, another it's $1.40 and $1.31, and I'm assuming it's based on the fact that type of structure and the sorts of things that fire response would be required of. But I don't understand what, how the amounts were determined. And I don't have a reason to disagree with them. I think it's quite okay. But at some point in time, and I don't see any reason to change them this time.
Right.
I just think at some point in time, we ought to investigate and see how they were arrived at, why they are the way they are, and if they're going to be adjusted. We know that there's adjustments made based on the assessed valuation, I suppose, from time to time, that's through the county auditor's office, or not auditor, but assessor's office. So my question is that not this year, but during the year, we take a look and see, and maybe it's only just because I'm a nerd and I want to know, but
well, it's been, never been changed, so I don't know.
Well, yeah, I mean, I know these have been happening for, I know the last 25 years, personally.
Well,
but
yeah, it was back. Very long.
Yeah, a long time ago. But,
yeah.
Where are those other
numbers?
Yeah, okay. Right.
Well, we can check on that.
I mean, in the meantime, I'd say we go ahead with what
okay.
we have.
Right.
Just based updating the 2016 value and so forth, but leaving the cost per hundred same as it is,
right.
Unless there's another formula out there that already calculates and adjusts the amounts.
Right. Okay. So, do we need to make a motion to do that, or do you want to then recalculate and then get you back?
Well, it looks like we're going to have to sign it at some point, so
right.
Might as well give us, bring us the updated things and then
we
can sign it.
We will do that.
At least that's my thought.
I agree. Okay. Selection of 30th firefighter.
So since we had our interviews, I think that's the board giving a recommendation on that, number one, two, or three.
Now we did the interviews the other night, we interviewed three, and got some good interviews, but I think the board's recommendation would be number three.
Or conditional.
Yeah, conditional offer.
Right. Okay. Second.
Second.
Fair to say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Let's make sure you got the condition.
Yep.
Signed and filled out. Okay. Anything else out there? I'd like to say something.
Yeah, I would like to thank Brendan for his year-end report. That was good.
Yeah.
Good report. Yeah, 6, 7 years up here. Perfect.
So we've got the Greensburg, we got the fire department tonight. Yeah.
Close to me.
Summary.
Second. favor, say aye.